قدر منو لیدونکو په امریکا کې د منځنۍ دورې د ټاکنو په ارزښت با خبرو تکینو چې پکې د ښځو ونډه خورا مهمه بلل کېږي. د منځنۍ دور په ټاکنو کې به د ښځو په فعالیتونو باندې د خپرونې محترمه میلمنه رڼا واچوي. د امریکا په پوهنتونونو کې د میرمنو د ټولنې مرستیاله لیسا ماتس موږ سره مل ده. خوشحاله یم موږ سره مل یاست. ډېره زیاته مننه. زما لومړۍ پوښتنه تاسو نه دا ده چې په دې ځل ټاکنو کې د ښځو دپاره تر ټولو مهمه مسله کومه مسله ده او د دوی اغېز به څنګه وي؟
How much influence?
Well, you know, women voters in the United States have a lot of power, and they can change the outcome of elections, but they can change it for good and for bad in some respects. If they show up, they can change the outcome of who's going to be elected, but also by virtue of the fact if they decide to stay home, if they decide not to vote, which we hope well, they won't, but if they do, that also can impact the election. So part of what we're looking for is a huge voter turnout for women, and I know that in terms of the national political stage for our Senate, it's going to be the difference. I think if women show up next week, then we will have a Democratic Senate. If women don't show up, or they show up in very small numbers, then we will have a Republican Senate.
So, in this
lobby, what
is the most important issue of women participation in this midterm election? And what issues will affect women voters?
Well, you know, I think that there are a lot of different issues that women care about, pay equity, equal pay, we also care about birth control issues, we care a lot about education and security. Unfortunately, a lot of times the politicians are not talking about that. And I think part of that is because, truthfully, a lot of the answers, particularly from very conservative politicians, are not something women want to hear. So instead of actually just being forthright with what they care about, they're trying to hide it, they're trying to sweep it under the rug. And I hope American women voters won't do that, won't let them do that. Because at the end of the day, in some respects, these midterm elections affect their daily lives even more than the presidential elections because it's Congress that passes the laws. Congress قوانین پاسوي او جمهور رئیس یې یوازې لاسلیک کوي.
Some experts predict a larger gender gap during this election. What might account for this possibility?
Well, you know, I think that when it comes to the gender gap in the United States, it's very interesting because more women vote and more women vote for the Democratic Party. So that's why there's such a hustle right now, such a big effort being put forth by the Republican Party. Because they know that if they want to take over the Senate, if they want to keep the House, they can't do it without women voters. Women voters will be the difference either because they showed up or because they didn't. But what's fascinating to me, and I think fascinating for your audience as well, is that if women are willing to come to the polls, they literally can make the difference in an election.
Another
important
is
if Hillary Clinton decides to run, and if she wins the 2016 election, would you care to speculate how a female president might handle foreign policy, especially what will be her policy towards Afghanistan?
Oh, you know, I think there are a lot of folks here in the United States that wish Hillary Clinton will run. I think it's still a bit of an open question. There's a lot of speculation. I think if she does run, she has an excellent chance of winning. She certainly knows what she's in for in terms of what the campaign's going to be. I think if she were to be elected, that Afghanis would find her to be similar in many respects in her foreign policy to President Obama. At the same time, she was a pretty independent Secretary of State. And we do know that one of the things she really cared about, in fact, she made it a focal point of her State Department, is making sure that women had access to equal rights, that women had access to the vote, that little girls had access to school. She very much believes that it takes a village to raise a child. And so I think in some respects, while some of it may feel familiar, I think some of it also will be probably an even more intense effort to help girls.
Lisa Matz, thank you very much for coming to our show and thanks for your insight.
My pleasure.
Thank you.